buffer, you can see this is input. Okay, our string to be parsed and marked with dollar. So always we put a dollar to, you know, as a terminating symbol. We enter a dollar as a terminating symbol, or we can say as an end mark. Okay. Output is a production rule which will be used. This is a production rule. Which will be used to parse tree. Right. Then we have a stack here, you can see, contains grammar symbols. At the bottom of the stack, there is special symbol marker, you know, end marker symbol dollar. So you can see the dollar is also there. Why? Reason is that when we have nothing to read from the, you know, input buffer, we'll get this end mark dollar here. Then we'll also reach to this dollar, or there should not be any symbol left in the, you know, stack to drive. If this dollar and this dollar matches, then only our parse tree completes. Okay. Now, initially, the stack contains only the symbol dollar and the string symbol and the starting symbol S. Okay. So, initial stack will look like this. Dollar you have. Then, if your starting symbol is S, S will be there. So, this is your initial condition. This is what is the initial condition of the stack. Now, when the stack is emptied, that is only dollar left, and the parsing, then the parsing is completed. Okay, and completed, it is successfully completed if this dollar and this dollar are going to match. Okay, so here. Parsing table, a two-dimensional array which gives you the match of A and A. Okay. Each row is a non-terminal symbol. You know, rows are for non-terminals. Each column is a terminal symbol. Columns are terminal symbol, you can see, or special symbol dollar. Okay. Each entry holds a production rule. Okay, so each entry is a production rule, okay, or it can be empty. Okay. Now, the symbol at the top of the stack, say X, and the current symbol in the input symbol, say A, determine the parser action. That means M here in the top of the stack is X, at top of current input symbol is A. So this tells you that production you have to use. Okay, there are four possible parser actions. If X and A are dollar, so if you get match dollar dollar, okay, then the parser halts and it say give you message successfully completed. Okay, successful completion. If X and A are same terminal symbol, and they are, you know, different from dollar, then parser pops X from the stack and moves to the next symbol in the input buffer. Right? If X is a non-terminal, then parser looks at the parsing table entry match XA. If match XA hold, then production rule X to, you know, Y1, Y2, YK is going to be chosen, and it pops X from the stack and pushes this body of that onto the stack. Okay, The parser also output the production rule this to represent the step of the derivation. Derivation is and derivation of the parse tree, right? So if none of the above, then it reports the error. Okay, all empty string in the parsing table are errors. We already know it. If X is terminal symbol different from A, this is also an error case. Okay, that means sometimes in the stack you are getting B and your input, you are getting current input is A, and on the top you are getting B. Then this match is not possible, right? So you will say that this is error. Okay. So here you can see that one parse table is given, okay, and one string is given. So what you have to do? Using a predictive parser or LLM parsing technique, you have to try to parse the given string. Okay, so for this thing, what we have learned till now, to do this, we will have three things in our hand. One is a stack, right? Another is input and output, correct? So initial configuration of the stack we already know that it will have dollar sign and s is the starting symbol here, so s, and input is given here is a b b a, so a b b a, and we will add a dollar as a terminating symbol. Okay, now you look at this. We have S here and A here. That means here we are, for this row we need a match of S comma A. So look at the table, S comma A, there is match. Yes, we have a match. That is S to A B A, or it also indicates if that if you are generating a parse tree, you go with like this. Sorry, I should not write there. Then you do it like S to A B A. Okay. So next, what is our, what action it will do? It will replace this S as it found a match here. It will replace this S by the body of it, and it will, pop out. It will pop out S from the stack, and it will push the body into the stack. Okay, so dollar will be there, A B A will be inserted into the stack. Okay, and we have A B B A dollar this stack. Now what is the match we need to find out? The top of the stack is small a, and current input symbol is also A. So match will be A comma A. So we found a match, right? So what will happen? We will pop out this A and this A. Okay? We pop out this two A, and there is no other action as output. Next, if you say the thing will look like, situation will look like after removing A. A and B is here. Here we have B, B, A, and dollar. So right now, our match to find is capital B, and current input symbol is B. So capital B and B, we have one production rule, that is B to B, capital B. Okay, so what we will do? What we'll do? We'll replace this B with this production body, right? So dollar A, this B will be popped out, okay? And this production body will be inserted. So as you are inserting in the stack, we will insert in reverse order. So B first, then small b, okay? We had B, B, A, a dollar here. So this B will be cancelled after that will matched. Okay. After that stack will look like A, B, where we have B, A, and dollar. Okay. Now what match you are trying to find out is B and small b. Okay. So B and small b we have already happened, so we know. The rule is B to this one, B to small b and capital B. Okay, so this B will be removed and popped out, and this will be inserted. So our stack will be like this: A, capital B first, small b. Okay, where B, A, and dollar. So this B and this B are matching, so they are going to be popped out. Okay, so next in our stack we have dollar A and capital B, where A and dollar. Okay, so our match right now is capital B and A. Capital B and A, we have an entry called B to epsilon. That means B to epsilon, if we replace this B by epsilon, what we will have? We have dollar A only here, B become epsilon, okay? And A and dollar will be there. So this A and this A match. What remains? Dollar in the stack, dollar here as a current input symbol. So dollar and dollar matched, so it will be accepted. Clear? So this is the procedure in Thresh. You can see. If you have any question or any doubt in this, you can ask me. You can put your question in the chat box as well. Okay, now if you think about the parse tree, you just take the outputs in what sequence you are getting and implement them. You will get the parse tree. If you want, you can see here. Yes, first one, what you have got? This rule, right? So S to A, capital B, and small. Next, what rule we have found? This number. B to small b, capital B. This was the third output. B to small b, capital B. Right? And this was the fourth output. B to epsilon. And there is no other output except. And we have, you can see, we have drawn a parse tree, which is A, B, B, epsilon, you forget, A, which gives the, which drives the input string A, B, B, A. Understand? So this is how we can automate a parsing technique for a given grammar and for a given input statement or string, how automatically it can be generated by a computer. Okay, so this is the sequence. You can see number one output, number two output, number three output, number four output. So this is the same sequence. If you drive, it will come like this. And this will be your first trip. Okay. So, if you remember this grammar, for this grammar we had already generated LL1 parse table, right? LL1 parse table we had generated. Anybody wants to generate it again? Okay, no, you don't need to generate it again. Okay, I have it. Okay, now point is that you have to parse the given string using this parse table. What is the given string? This one. Okay, so let me show you how it can happen. Okay, so we'll have three things. Stack, input, and output. Okay, so your stack will be initial configuration, will have dollar and E is the starting symbol here, right? And our input string is given ID plus ID dollar. Okay. So let's go with it. Our match, first match we are searching for is top of the stack, and current input symbol is ID. So EID is the current thing what we are searching for. If you see here, EID is having an entry E2TE dash, we have, right? So this E will be popped out and E dash T will be entered here, and ID plus ID dollar will be here. Okay. Next, our match we search for T and ID as a current input symbol. So T ID we have TF T to F T dash, right? T to F T dash. So this T is going to be popped out, okay? Dollar E dash T dash F ID plus ID dollar. Okay. Next is F ID. If you see F with ID, there we have a entry F to ID. So we have F2ID, right? So this F will be replaced by ID. So E dash T ID. We have ID plus ID dollar here. So this ID match. So we will have in our hand E dash T plus ID dollar here. Okay. So current match we are searching for is T and this plus, right? So to say T and plus, you have a production rule here. You can see I have underlined. That is E dash to plus T dash. Okay. So E dash, this T is going to be replaced with E dash T plus, and we have plus ID and dollar here. So this plus and this plus matched. Okay, so right now we have T at the top and ID. So T and ID, if I search for a match, we are going to get T FT dash. T to F T dash. So this T will be replaced by this production body, which will give us dollar E dash, E dash, T dash, and F, rare, ID, and dollar. So F and ID, if you match, then you are going to get F to ID. This entry is there here in this table. Okay, so the stack will be dollar E dash, again E dash, and F is replaced by ID. Okay, and ID and dollar here. Okay, so this ID matched. Our current stack becomes E dash, E dash, and only dollar here. Okay, so E dash to dollar, if you see, E dash here, dollar here. So we have a production rule, E dash to epsilon. Okay, so this E dash will become epsilon. We will have dollar and E dash and dollar here. So again, the same match we will get, E dash to epsilon. This E dash is replaced by dollar and epsilon. So we'll have only dollar in the stack, only dollar at the output. So this dollar match, we will say accept. Clear?